me go over this really quick, I guess. Since the last stream, you may remember, I have just a little bit of trouble with Ozma. So if I go into the menu here, I can show you. Open menu. Now, you might notice everyone's level 99. That's a thing. You might also notice that level 99 is actually not that much more powerful than level 80, which is about what we were before. And hello, Uzu. It's, yeah. Put it this way, I think at 80, Steiner had somewhere in the region of, like, 6,500 HP. He's got 7,500 now. Aha! So Curse is still going to be our biggest problem. We've equipped everything we can, really, to counter that. We all, I think, absorb holy shadow damage, so Doomsday won't affect us. There's going to be still a lot of RNG in this boss fight, unfortunately, even at level 99, but we've done what we can. We have Quina. The reason we have Quina is because, as someone suggested, if we go down to Angel Snack, it uses a remedy on all party members, so in one turn, we can remedy them all of any status, aka, for the most part, Minnie is going to be the problem. She also has Mighty Guard, which casts Shell and Protect on everyone. Protect, not really going to be any use whatsoever, because Ozma doesn't do physical attacks, but he does do magical attacks, so. Basically, we want to bust out Mighty Guard as soon as the fight starts, then we want to pop Angel Snack anytime we're in trouble, and we probably want a White Wind in between that just to get some HP back. We're probably not going to really attack much with Quina at all. Maybe we'll have to, I don't bloody know. So, we'll see how this goes. Hello, Dire Raven, that's so Raven. Alright, let's do this shit. Ozma? Get mine, you son of a bitch! Get mine! Probably not mine, but we'll see how it goes. Okay. Let me have a freaking go. Bloody hell already! Death, oh lovely. Alright, use Flare Sword. Don't use Flare Sword, you're dead. Fair enough. You smack it. Bloody hell. Alright, let's revive Steiner. You use Mighty Freaking Guard so that when Steiner gets up, Mighty Guard, right? Beautiful, that's a lot of damage, Dane. Love it, love it. Use Flare Sword. Wait, someone said instead of using the Flare Sword thing to use Shock, which is an ability we have on him, so we should be doing that. So I'm a moron. Can you use Mighty Guard before we fight? Oh, there it is. Shit. Shit, shit, shit. Steiner's dead again. I hate everything. This is gonna happen a bunch of times though, so just get used to it. It's going to happen. I love you, Jason. Curse lit. For some reason that isn't loading for me, I just see the words curse lit. Okay. What the hell was that? Oh, that was auto potion. Okay, that's fine. Hurry up! It takes so bloody long is the problem. Mighty Guard! They're great! Yeah, still need to use Angel Snack, because two of them are still bloody tiny. And again, we gotta get in damage. She's gonna remember Ozma will cost Cure Guard itself, and it restores like, what, 7,000-ish? That's a lot. Like, a lot. Okay. Okay, Angel Snack. Please don't kill any- just like, give me a break. Do Doomsday or something. Come on, buddy, Doomsday. Holy. I think most of our people are either immune to Holy or are going to take about half damage. It probably will kill Steiner though, which is the problem, because Steiner just keeps bloody dying. Okay, everyone is alive. Take the opportunity whilst you have it, do some bloody damage. You use Shock because by that point you should be okay. You're returning Holy on it. It might absorb that. That might not be the best idea. That's an ability I have called Return Magic. Might not have been my wisest plan. My love for you, Jason, is burning with the fires of hate. Cool! Thanks. I think I actually did do damage. Alright, we got off Angel Snack. This is going much better already. We're still alive. That in itself means it's going much better. Stop it! Why must you ruin everything? Fucking hell! Alright, so everything I just did is gonna hit, like, pants. Just absolute pants. Alright, speed up. All the, like, four auto potions, man. Alright. Okay, let's see how this goes. This is unfortunate. We could, yeah, you see what I mean? We could have got off a lot of damage there. Had you just used basically anything but Curse, we'd have been cool. Kiriga. Alright, well, I mean, you know, you do you, I suppose. Yeah, there goes, oh, fuck nuts. Yeah, there he goes with Shock, which is gonna do jack shit now. That's embarrassing. That's actually quite a lot of damage, though, considering how tiny he was. Mr. Dane only did 70, so that was probably going to hit pretty bloody hard. Honestly, as annoying as it is that he's still Kyogre-ing himself and getting a fuck ton of HP back, it's better he does that than kills us. So I'll take what I can get, right? I realize it's not your turn yet, but you really need to use motherfucking Angel Snack, because we're going to do jack shit down. Okay, that was a couple of thousand. That's at least something. He's got double magic because he's in trance. Kyogre again? Bloody hell! Alright, I mean, sure, whatever. Just double flare him. There you go. Alright. Now, let me attack with my people. Please. All I want to do is damage you and murder you horribly, you weird giant marble, bouncy ball, whatever the hell you are, thing of death. That is perfect. Thank you. Did we ever get off that mighty guard? Probably not. Let's do it again. Alright. Alright, I like this. I don't think anyone's going to take damage from this, I hope. We'll see. And Ozma does take damage from this, we know that. So this should just be a free hit on him. We all good? We all good. We're all good, fantastic. And you're returning Doomsday. It's even better. Oh my gosh. Well, we just saw the animation. It's speed enough, speed enough. Aha! This is going very well. I'm excited! Yes! Got 9999 on the bastard as well. Oh yeah! Take that, you little bitch! Oh, by the way, I looked up lore on this thing. There isn't really much. People are speculating that, or did speculate, I guess, because the game came out a long time ago. People were speculating that, essentially, since it's in an Eidolon cave, it's some kind of Eidolon, but they couldn't harness its powers, so they locked it away, and it seems to be some kind of combination of light and darkness, since it uses holy and shadow magic. You see, the top is kind of whitish, the bottom's kind of darkish. Yeah, it's about all they got, really. And the other one, which sounds kind of out there to me, really, is that they were saying that essentially they think that because it was so long ago and it was locked away and kept secret and blah de blah, that they probably don't... The way it looks is probably because it lost form over that time, because, you know, it was locked away, it couldn't be seen, no one spoke of it, blah blah blah, so it became this weird shape. Thing. I don't know. It's just a massive energy, basically.
I'm blind.
Two other people are berserked. That's a problem. Angel Snack, I don't think he's going to cure it, which is... Yeah. I'm going to use the green zone Vivi. I don't mind too much if Steiner's going ham with a berserk. Please don't cast mini on everyone. Okay, you missed. Oh, wait. Zidane's mini. Son of a bitch! Why are you returning mini on Ozma? That ain't going to work, man. Ain't gonna work. Hello, Finder. How's it going, dude? It ain't gonna work. What are you doing? I will mass his energy. I'll bet. Kyogre. Okay. Well, you know. We take what we can get, I suppose. Instead of doing it again with... And by it, I mean Angel Snack again with Quinna. Just gonna use a remedy with Zidane, since he can't really do anything in the meantime because he's tiny. Bam, bam. Yeah, get green, son. Beautiful. Okay, so the only one going ham is Steiner. Again, he's our physical attacker, so it's not the end of the world. What are you doing now? Flare Star. Okay, that hurt like hell, from what I remember. So we try White Wind if we're actually friggin' alive. This might just kill us. Yo, my. Well, Vivi's dead. Oh, he's got auto life. That's right. It's delightful. Sure, just try double black magic, man. We need to do some damage. So why did it only let me cast flare once? I thought I had to select it twice. I'm now concerned. We still send through water potion? No, okay, there's the remedy. I'm kind of nervous, so I don't want to spend the whole stream fighting this fucker.
Yes! Do all of the damage!
Really kind of want to try and steal from him, but I'm not going to! I don't care that much about the random crap that he has. You know, we're gonna beat the game anyway, so fuck it. Let's just kill him. Or her. It. It's probably not got a gender, let's be honest. Kyogre, okay. That's fine. I'm actually gonna use Angel Snack in preparation of it using Curse. This may be completely redundant, but at worst, we wasted one turn. I wouldn't be surprised to see it happen, though. Because it's been a while, and this motherfucker loves his curse. Or, its curse. So we'll see how it goes. Yeah, it's in preparation.
Preparation.
Bloody hell. How many times do I have to watch player? I don't care. There you go. Now, we've done a decent amount of damage. He has cured a lot. That's probably going to be Kurigar again. Yep. Get used to it, man. Get used to it. Alright. That's a lot of HP you just got back. We took off most of it. Steiner, isn't it your turn yet? Good lord, sir. Don't do it again. What the? Bloody hell. Hello, host. How's it going, dude? Okay, so it was redundant. Well, whatever. That's fine. It's fine. It's fine. Meteor. Oh, dear. I think Meteor is the move that I read that it's very random. Holy shit, how much damage it does. This time, it decided to do a metric fuckdown. Vivi needs to be revived, really. Okay.
Shit. Shit. Shit, white wind.
We need to get some freaking HP back. Don't curse me. Don't curse me. Don't curse me. Okay. That's annoying, but, you know, whatever. Speed up. Please. No, it cursed. No. Why? It was going so well. Okay, we're not doomed yet. That's gonna kind of fuck us, though. Two people are dead. It's a real problem. Alright, we got Vivi back up. Shit, dude. Shit. I have to get Quinter up. I have to. I have an Alexia. Oh, shit. Come on, what are you doing? Let's use an Alexia on Vivi since, No. Yeah, Vivi, fuck it. And now Steiner, we can't do much with him. Woot, drunk stream. Are you drunk? I'm not drunk. I wish I were drunk. Why? Why? RIP Steiner, you will be missed, man. You will be missed. Drinking a banana smoothie. Swish. And thinking about the host wolf.
Okay. We're alive. This is the important part.
Oh shit. Oh shit. Well, I mean, you know what? Just smack it, Zidane. Gotta take what we can get at this point. Yes, auto push. Lovely. Auto push. Okay, we did some damage. I don't care if people are dead. Like, as long as it dies, I don't really care what kind of state we're in. So, any chance I get to smack it with Zidane, I'm gonna be smacking it with Zidane. It's Curse Man. That's the one move. It's got that one move that you don't want it to do. I've complained about this in Dark Souls before. Like, any boss that has a very RNG moveset where some moves are way more... Oh, shit. Some moves are way more dangerous than others. It makes it very, very luck-based. Like the Four Kings, for example, where they do that ground slam or the grab attack or the boomerangs and all that shit that just waste time. Yeah. Quinter, I really need you to, like, fucking... stop sucking balls and do Angel Snack. I mean, I realize I didn't tell you to do that, but I gotta revive people. Ah, bloody hell. I'm waiting to use an Elixir on her. On him, rather. There you go. Please don't kill him yet. I mean, you're probably gonna do it eventually, but don't do it yet. If you kill yourself, I'll accept that. Okay, that's fine. That's fine. What do I do? Oh, that's right. Angel Snack. Quickly. Quickly. Go, go, go. Okay. Alexia, yes. Yes, like it. Really want to use Mighty Guard as well, but, you know, one thing at a time. No point me attacking it, because he's tiny. You can't even see him. He's, like, down below the little bar thing. Why am I fighting a giant jawbreaker? I wish I knew. It's just an optional boss in this game that looks like, you know, a gobstopper, bouncy ball, marble thing. But you're right, it does look probably the most like a jawbreaker from, what's that damn movie? You know the one. Oh, shit. Oh, it's Doomsday, okay, good. It looks like a jawbreaker from, Charlie and the Chocolate Factory. Like, it really does. Boop. You smack it, and we're just gonna keep angel snacking. We're just going to keep doing that. We have plenty of remedies. I mean, it's costing 4 every freaking time, but I did buy 99. Hello, guys. How are you doing, good sir? I tell you, like the dog picture on YouTube.
Yeah.
Doomsday, you little bitch!
I mean, he's cured a lot. He, she, one. It has cured a lot. But, I mean, we're chipping away, surely. Surely we're chipping away at this motherfucker. Get chipped, you bastard.
Shocking!
Is this our first time using shock in the whole fight?
Victory! Get to war! Sit your ass down, you giant bouncy ball son of a bitch!
We did it!
We did it!
Oh god, okay.
Fuck you, Wazma!
Okay. I need a moment. I got an achievement called To Ozma and Back. It's like To Hell and Back. Okay, so this pumice, I believe, teaches Garnet, who we're gonna switch back in for, instead of Quinna, because I like Quinna. I don't know, I think she's awesome, but Garnet's better in my opinion. We're gonna switch Garnet back in, and the pumice actually teaches her her ultimate summon, which is called Arc, I do believe. You're very strong, Kupo! That's amazing, Kupo! So there is a point to doing this. That's how you get Arc. I don't think you can get it any other way. Actually, no, I think you can. But it's kind of, it's secret. Anyway, I recorded how I feel right now on card, Kupo. I'll give you secret info too. You have too many cards. I'm gonna leave it here, Kupo. Receive strategy guide. One more bonus, Kupo. Sweet, thanks. So you get a card for it as well. It might be like an Ozma card or something. I don't care about the cards, to be honest. So if it gets discarded, eh, whatever. We did it. We bloody did it. No, it didn't kill me with its sweet sugarness yet. That's what happens when you're level 99 instead of 80. It was actually doable. Though still fucking hard, as you saw. Like, we need to be prepared, and even then... Almost killed us all several times. Ain't an easy boss! How do I leave this place? Is it this whole thingy over here? Yeah, here we go. Go back! Go back! So there is one more option of boss, and it's in the final dungeon of the game called Memoria, which is on top of the Ifa tree. I don't remember where the boss is. I know I killed it before a long time ago, but... So if anyone is familiar with this game in the chat and knows where that boss is, and when I get there just reminds me, that would be very handy, though I don't know if anyone is. Right, so we want to change characters, so we need to get back on the ship, the Hildegard, or whatever it's called. It's not called Hildegard now, is it? Oh, the Invincible, there you go. Alright, let's go get our Invincible back. There you are, the Invincible in all of its glory. That's right, we need to land in a bush. I knew that. Don't know why it's a thing, but it is. Let's get back in you. And then switch party members. It's been a pleasure, Quinna. You carried us. I love you. Quip. You take this pumice. If I can find the bloody thing. Wait, you haven't learned MP plus 20%? You suck. There you go, Ark. Bloody Ark. Okay, so what summons does she have? I feel like we're missing, like, Alexander. Oh, that's right, she doesn't learn Alexander, I'm pretty sure, Eco learns that. So yeah, we have all of them now. Shiva, Ifrit, Ramu, Atomos, Odin, or Atomos, Odin, Leviathan, Bahamut, and Ark. Costs 80 bloody magic to use. We should get rid of Auto Potion for now, just so when we run into random battles, we don't get annoyed by it. But, yes. Well, so I know for a fact that you want Body Temp equipped for, what's his damn name? The next optional boss. So we'll equip that, and then I don't think we need Locomotion, so we'll get rid of that. Put Body Temp on instead. You have enough points. There's Body Temp. And Locomotion. Body Temp. Okay, everyone got Auto Potion off? Yes. Excellent. Again, I would like to point out that Ozma has a pumice piece, a dark matter, which will make Odin stronger, and something else pretty good. Those two in particular, I think, are what you want. So yeah, you are actually, there are things you want to steal from him as well. I just couldn't be bothered. I don't care enough. We're about to finish the game anyway, so you know, fuck it. Let's go over to the Ifa tree. I think it's on this continent, isn't it? How's the last boss called, do you know? I know what the last boss is. It's not really going to be what you expect, we'll put it that way. Let me see if it's... Oh, the optional boss. It's called Hades. It's not really a spoiler. But yeah, I know it's in the final dungeon. There's like, essentially, you know when you find something in this game that you can click on, it's like an exclamation point? I know there's no exclamation point for Hades. There's like a room, it's like at the back of the room or something, and you have to click on it, and you don't know it's there. So it's super secret. And then it pops up and he addresses you and you can fight him. And if you've already killed Ozma, he's kind of impressed by that, so... We've already killed Ozma. I think he's weaker than Ozma, but not by much. He's still a pain in the dick. Whoa! I still have it on speed up! I can't slow it down! Why? Alright, hang on. This is why we save it before we do things like that. It would not let me turn off the speed up. So, yeah. We almost missed that entire badass cutscene, so let me just reload into the game. We'll turn the speed up off before we go in there, and then we can actually watch the goddamn cutscene. So you either beat a giant jawbreaker, or kill a bowling ball, or a murderous marble. How do you feel? I feel pretty good about it. Pretty good. Yeah, a fast-paced shooter, yep. FF3 is only $16 on Steam. Yeah, I'd wait for a sale though, because it's kind of expensive for an old ass game. I think 3 is considered one of the worst ones, though probably still pretty good. I do own 3, I haven't played it yet. I played like the first 20 minutes or something. I was like, this seems okay. So are you noticing here that that dragon that Kuja was riding seems to be like 1,000 of them now? Warship Scarf Path for the Invincible! Can't let you guys steal the show by yourselves. I can't skip the text, so it's just gonna go at its own speed. Uncle Sid? Why? How did he know to show up here? Probably because of Baku, he loves big showdowns. Now, let's lose those dragons! Oi! Oh, you put the location of Hades. Thank you. I will check it out in a moment. General Beatrix, our ship is going to burst. And so am I. Do not fret. Your captain is about to enter Valhalla. That's Nordic heaven. You're a Pluto Knight. Now act like one, you little bitch. We all know you came along because you were worried sick about Captain Steiner. Did you say something? Red Rose? Could it be Beatrix?
My love!
Quite a woman you fell in love with. You're one to talk. Wait a minute, Steiner, what do you mean by that? Alright, let's bust through. Can't really scroll back in the chat right now because of the cutscene. As soon as it's done, I will. Well, what the hell? Okay, I guess we have a battle. That's a cool-looking dragon. Before we fire that, let me get the location of Hades. It's on paste in the chat very kindly. Let me copy-paste it into a document so I don't lose it. Alright. Let's open Notepad. Boop! Alright, we got it. We got it. Let's put it down there. I can read it that way. Beautiful. Alright, let's carry on. So, straight into another boss fight, eh? Alright then. Shugging! I don't think this thing's gonna give us that much trouble compared to what we just dealt with, but I could be wrong. Nova Dragon, alright. That's a cool name. Sure, we'll give him a flare. Ooh, we have some... Ooh, let's use Arc. Causes shadow damage to all enemies. If you live that long, you're gonna suck some arc. That's probably gonna hurt. Not half as much as, what's his name? Do shock again. Yeah! He's all tranced and shit. Ooh, so are you. Why'd you get tranced now, like, after we beat Ozma? Could've used that during the fight, I'm just saying. Just saying. But yeah, I will point out that auto life and auto regen seemed almost essential for Ozma. Like, without those, I think we would've died. Remedy. Remedy? Give me a bloody remedy! I'm just sticking remedy. Let's use Grand Lethal. Actually, no, I think Solution 9's better for 1-2, something like that. Just gonna do a lot of damage? Yeah! Yeah, we're quite powerful now. Quite powerful. You once knew a guy who called himself Nova, was a grade-A prick. He sounds like one. Boop. Low-key, I always thought Cloud of Darkness from FF3 should have been the boss here. I, again, don't know enough about it to know what boss that is. Check out Ark, yes. It's some kind of a ship. I don't know why. It also appears to be in space. It's like a Transformer ship. Pretty cool though, right? Jason overpowered. Eh. For the regular game at this point, yes, we probably will be. But that's the thing. To beat Ozma, you kinda need to be level 99. We don't need to be, but as you saw, he still almost killed us. I think Ozma and Hades are probably tougher than the final boss, which is a weird thing they tend to do, so, besides Hades, we should be mostly fine now, but we'll see how it goes. Don't get me wrong, though, final boss ain't gonna be no walk in the park. He's still gonna be hard. How long is the summon animation? Good God. It's a Transformer Optimus. Indeed. It really is like a Transformer, though. It does, like, Pharah's Rocket Barrage from Overwatch. Justice reigns from above! Did you grind on the sheeple? I ground on the sheeple for a bit and then I gave up and went back to the dragons. It was very boring, very boring. It's still going. This is still the same summon animation. Holy crap. Like, they want you to know this is the ultimate summon. It's still going! Is that a Titan mech? I mean, I guess. All of that for 999. I mean, you can't go over that. Oh, I got an achievement called Firing My Laser. It's even spelled My Laser. Alright, let's not use that ever again, because that was very, very long. Cool, but long. Let's use Bahamut. Actually, no, I guess we'd probably get the abbreviated version now, wouldn't we? So glad they added that in. Whoa. That was awesome, man! Let's use Klimhazard. I like Klimhazard. I like the color of Klimhazard. I don't know why. That's Bastion's attack, let's be real. No, Bastion doesn't use Rocket. Well, I guess he kind of uses Rockets when he does his ult. But they're not like that. Alright, where's Mio Twister? Sure, let's use Mio Twister. I don't think it's going to survive that long, I'll be honest. I think this might kill it. Yeah, it's down. You can tell because the HP bars are gone. That, my friend, is called an ass whopping. His tail's flickering. What's he doing? Cool death animation. I don't remember anything about this final dungeon, by the way. Like, I really don't. Actually, no, that's a lie. I think I remember it being green. I think I remember, like, a really green room, or maybe the whole thing's really green. That's all I do remember, though. Are you sure this will work, Quinna? Is no problem. I warp in front, outside, before. I guess this is the only exit, anyway. We find same magic field outside when we come back. I warp in when I step into magic field outside. Alright. I guess it's no use worrying. I don't know what she's talking about. You're 27 hours without sleep and you're sitting here watching my stream. Well, I appreciate that, man. You should get some sleep, though. Sleep is important. It keeps the brain alive. What is this place? This is Memoria, you punk. What's wrong, Zidane? Did someone just call my name? No. That's weird. Maybe you're just hearing things. I don't think so. Zidane! You hear that? That was great timing on my behalf. I hear nothing. Zidane, can you hear me? Garland? I am speaking only to you. Garland, what is this place? Memoria, a place of memories. I had a feeling that that would, yeah. I mean, Memoria, memories. I thought that's where they were going. The Green Dungeon is the Northern Crater, the final dungeon of seven. No, it's definitely nine I'm thinking of. Maybe it's not this one, but I do remember like a really green room. It could have been somewhere we've already been though. Memories? Yes, your memories brought forth this place. Here you shall witness the entire truth. You have no choice, now go. What are you talking about?
Answer me, damn you! Damn it!
Zidane, what's going on? He's losing his bloody marbles, we should put him down. You all heard me talking, right? Looks like I was the only one who heard him. I was just talking to Garland. He told me that our memories created this place. He said Zidane's memories. He didn't say ours. He didn't include everyone else. Maybe he was meaning to, but he didn't. So why are you assuming that? I don't know. You're wrong, monkey boy. I don't know what the hell he's talking about. I guess we'll just have to move forward. Yeah, we got the right team. Let's go. Check out the music, by the way. I'll shut up. Garland has been in way too many FF games. Same with Gilgamesh, has he? Oh, that's how you go back to the Invincible.
Invincible!
I remember these weird bubbly things. Aren't these like save points or some shit? Yeah, okay. So save points are weird here. Yeah, that's strange. I guess they're going for like, that they're supposed to look like memories, since we're in Memoria, and he jumps in them, and it's like, a save is like a memory, I guess. I don't know. Cavern of Stolen Faith, where a Tombury is in FF10. It could be that as well, I don't know. Not really, well, not surprised we're getting battles here. We're not really going to get anything out of it is the problem, because we don't need to level up anymore. Holy shit. But, you know, if it's a new enemy, we'll have a look. That looks like a Chimera to me. Terrifying Chimera. It's a Chimera wrench. Let's use Klim Hazard. It looks cool. And then we'll smack it. And then Shaw. Let's use Odin. We're hitting like a truck. I like it. Let's try Venom Breath. Oh, you bastard.
Meteor! Oh.
It was a round green room. I still think I'm thinking of this game, but maybe I'm thinking of somewhere else. I just have a memory of... I think I remember playing cards in there as well. I remember playing cards in a really green dungeon-looking room. Definitely in 9. And we haven't done that so far, which is what's leading me to believe it must be the final dungeon I'm thinking of. But again, maybe I'm wrong. Yeah, get Odin, you little bitch. I love Odin, man. He's so cool the way he just... You know, the same way an action hero walks away from, like, an explosion. He does that, like, he cuts them and then just casually walks away, like, with his back turned to them like a badass. That's a lot of EXP that we don't need. Sweet. Sweet. Stop walking in the walls, you idiot. Fuck Gwent. Gwent is awesome. We seem to have some dissension in the ranks here about Gwent. I had to clear my throat. Okay. So, I mean, this is kind of green, but I remember it being, like, really dark green. Oh, why do I remember this? Where is it? And yeah, again, I remember something to do with cards there as well. Why can I walk out here? What's the purpose of this? I don't understand. Yeah, Gilgamesh is in a lot of games as well. I think he's in like 4, apparently in 6. He's definitely in 8. And he's not in 10. That's Yojimbo, who is essentially Gilgamesh. He's an iron giant, isn't it? An Iron Man! They called him an Iron Man now? Iron Man! You're an Iron Giant, you motherfucker! You can change your name when you please! You're still an Iron Giant! You little bitch! Let's speed up this animation, cause good lord. Oh, really? I have to watch the whole thing again? Even at triple speed, this is gonna take too damn long. It's so fucking slow! Well, long, I guess. Triple speed, I remind you. Triple speed. Bloody hell. I want to see what the Shu animation is. I don't think this thing's gonna live that long. I enjoyed Dark Souls reference. No. This came out like 20 years before Dark Souls. Iron Giants have been around since like Final Fantasy 2, I think. I think if anything, the giant in Dark Souls was probably a reference to Final Fantasy. I would be surprised if it wasn't. Though, I mean, it's kind of a generic thing. Isn't there a movie called like the Iron Giant, which looks a lot like the one in Dark Souls? It could be a reference to that. I mean, it's just a giant dude in armor. It could be a reference to nothing. It's hard to say. I'm trying to talk over the music and, you know, ruin the atmosphere. The battles are kind of ruining the atmosphere on their own, though. Oh, by the way, for those of you that missed it, what is that? That's cool looking. Wait, is this a boss? This is boss music. We meet again. I'm one of the Chaos Guardians. Oh, the ones that were guarding those mirrors. Kneel before my power. I'm going to have to fight with four of them, aren't I? Son of a bitch. All right, strap yourselves in. We're in for a bumpy ride. Flame slash, let's use bottom up. It's gonna hurt. Actually didn't hurt that much. You are quite pathetic. Alright. Flare! There, great! I guess we'll try and steal with you, just to give it a chance. Flare again! Oh yeah, for those of you that missed it, when we finish Final Fantasy IX, which could happen this stream, if not almost certainly the next stream, I will be going through my list of games that I have bought on Steam. That I never played with the intention of playing. Single player ones, gonna not do RPGs for the most part because they're too long. And we're gonna play through them. Just, you know, one by one, gonna go through them. If I get to a point where I don't want to play anymore, we'll just stop. But for the most part, we're probably gonna complete them. Stuff like Shovel Knight, Aragami, Dungeons of Dreadmore I have to try out. No, I don't know if that's a game you can quote-unquote really complete. Fucking hell, what else do I have? I have so many of them that I bought and just haven't played yet. Like, a lot. And I can't remember any others off the top of my head right now, because my memory is shit. Oh! Slain Back from Hell Edition. There's so many that I need to go through. I'm not gonna steal, I don't care about stealing anymore. Danganronpa maybe? Well, that's the thing, I don't own that. So I do want to play, and I will, but I need to go through some of the things on my Steam list first. That's kind of half the reason we're doing it, is because I need to stop buying games and then not playing them. Like, I want to play these games, and this is going to be a way of me forcing myself to play them by streaming them. Speaking of streaming, we will be going back to two solo streams per week. One on Friday, aka today, and one on Tuesday. Now, that could change depending on if, you know, I don't feel up to it and blah, blah, blah. But generally speaking, those are going to be the days where I solo stream. The other days are going to be the co-op ones that we do, where we play Overwatch or whatever we do. Tabletop Simulator, stuff like that, with, you know, Reaper Kirsty and Azu and the gang and such. So, there you go. Bloody hell am I fed up of seeing these animations. God lord. Alright, that wasn't exactly 9999, but I think it was worth it for the time that we saved. Jason's favorite attack, Mustard Bomb. We should be immune to that now, because we have body temp on. So hopefully we're okay. Can you, like, die? Fucking hell. We have so much issues, Leviathan, just to be different. And you, I'm gonna give you a shock. Sword Quiver. I'm so scared. He's probably gonna counterattack or something. Hey, Chunchy, you bought the swindle. I don't think so. I'll go through them in a minute. You know, when we finish this fight, I'll read you some of them. There you go. It's fucking dead. Bastard. It's over. What's it doing? Take this. This is like some kind of final blow, isn't it? Raining swords. That's pretty cool. Was that really all you had? You suck. I think that was a lady. It appeared to have boobsicles. I got an achievement called Putting Out the Fire. They thought long and hard about the name of that one, quite clearly. Alright, let me go through some of the games. Probably make a poll at some point, though I don't know if all of those will be on the poll, because otherwise it will get very, very confusing for people. We'll probably do like 10 at a time per poll or something like that. Anyway, that's carry on. Isn't this Alexandria? What is Alexandria Castle doing here? That's why he doesn't have the money to go to America. A lot of those were gifted to me. A lot of those came in like, you know, Humble Bundles and things like that. And a lot I did buy with the intention of playing and haven't got to yet. I think I missed a few there as well. Because I don't remember saying Shovel Knight, but yes, that one's there somewhere. What are you talking about? I not see anything. Of course, you can't see anything. You weren't with us at the time, so it's not in your memory, eh? Warhammer 40k Dawn of War 2 is also quite good. In his bid to defy me, Kuja tried to acquire Alexander. An incident 10 years ago started everything. I'll bet. I will bet. So we're just gonna learn a bunch of memories and shit now. That's cool. I'm gonna turn Bowers off, because I just don't care enough. I don't want to get interrupted, to be honest. A storm. Whoa, what the hell was that? Oh. See, look, cards! I knew it! This is the room I was thinking of! Defense Phantom, I'm the ghost of the most infamous card master. Are you challenging me? Fuck no. Discretion is the better part of valor. I'll agree with that, yeah, I need to save before I challenge you. I mean, we might give him a go or two. This was the room. It's not half as green as I was remembering, but yes, this is the room. And there's the card dude. See, I'm not crazy. It's just not as green as I thought it was, but it is green. Oh yeah, I should read where the fight is with Hades. Hey, what are you doing? You shouldn't go anywhere, there's a storm. Watch out, you're gonna get washed away. That's obviously Mini Zidane. Dagger, I just saw a little girl on a ship and... Oh, maybe there's Dagger. Huh? I guess it was my imagination. It had to be. What I just saw definitely isn't one of my memories. What's going on? That was my memory. Why was Zidane able to see it? Zidane? And you, God? Yeah, what's up? You didn't imagine anything. Wait, you saw it too? That means that little girl was you? I'm very confused right now. But why was I able to see something from your memory? I don't know. Dun, dun, dun! Hey, Garland, what's going on? Garland, can you hear me? I do not own Stardew Valley, that's correct. Again, I'm reluctant to buy new things because I have so many things to finish. I feared Gaia's Eidolons more than anything, however, I decided to deal with them before they became a major problem. Okie dokie. A save point would be really handy. What is that thing? That eye. It's the same eye I saw in the night of the storm at sea. Zidane, can you hear me? Zidane, what you just saw was from your memory and not from Garnet's. What? I don't remember ever being in a storm at sea. You still don't understand. You will find out soon enough. What do you mean? Can other people see... Can other people's memories become a part of my own? Garland! Once you accept everything, the answer will appear before you. A tremendous force was summoned to Gaia during the Age of War. However, the Gaians were not ready to harness so great a power. They were terrified and broke the jewel into four pieces, and they prayed never to see it again. Okay. Save point. Oh, is this... That's not Hades. That's Rune Claws. The Ultimate Claws. Apparently they are the Ultimate Claws. Okay. Cool. That was an achievement I got, in case you're wondering why I just said that. Right. Let me have a look at this thing real quick. In memoria, after a save, you will come to a room where Quino... Okay. We should just switch behind the ledge. Okay. So we aren't there yet. Let's keep going. This is a bus, because we have encounters off. Again, I had a feeling we were going to fight all four of these guardian things of the mirror. Ooh, it's the dragon one. So you have defeated Maliris. For Tiamat, there is only victory. Now it's Tiamat. Sweet. I'm going to kill you too. Jetfire. Terrifying. Oh, you got me. You got me, champ. What do we have here? I don't know, why am I going through this? I should be going through the summons. God, I don't want to use Ark, it's so bloody long! Let's use Odin. Odin's cool. We'll see if Odin does do damage to bosses. Let's use Shuck. At this point, it's all gravy until we get a Hades in the final boss. Yes, I think so. I don't think these things are going to put out much of a fight. Really, Zidane? You were 9 damage off doing max? You suck. You really suck. Speed up! Yeah! I like how blunt Odin's sword looks. Styx is going to be too hard for casual Jason. Hey man, I can do stealth and shit. I used to play Tenchu. I got, what was it, like, Grand Master or whatever on all of the missions in Tenchu 1 and 2. I used to be good at video games of some description. Certainly not all video games. Some of them I've been really bad at and that's never changed, but I did used to be good at stealth, believe it or not. Am I fighting Cthulhu? It looks a bit like it, but apparently this is a dragon, because this is Tiamat. Which was, like a weird... kind of like a weird version of Bahamut, I think, in Final Fantasy VIII. We fought it in Ultimisu's castle at the end. These bosses are a reference to the first Final Fantasy. They are the exact same bosses you faced to get the four crystals. In the final dungeon, you fought all of them again. Ooh! Yes, I didn't get very far in the first Final Fantasy. That game is fucking hard. Requires you to do a shitload of grinding. Like, a lot. And I got very bored of grinding. I do own it on my... actually, no, it's not on this phone. I think it's on one of the first phones I ever got. Well, no, that's not true either. One of the first smartphones I ever got. I got Final Fantasy 1 on it. But I no longer have it. The phone or the game. Oh my god, the summon anime. So long. Yeah. Get freaking melted. God, I hope Hades doesn't give us trouble. And we've got an achievement called Gone with the Winds. That's a reference to the book, Gone with the Wind. Stop walking into the war, Zidane, you punk-ass bitch. Ooh, this place looks cool. I mean, it's a final dungeon, it probably should. Everything's burning! But yeah, you saw there was an invisible card dude in a kind of green room. Not half as green as I thought, but I was not crazy. Jason Styx is very hardcore stealth, makes Dishonored and Mark of the Ninja look like tutorials by comparison. There's another card dude here. Strong Phantom. I'm the ghost of a warrior card master. Interesting. I shall take you on any time. I'll bet, but not right now. It's totally worth it though, a very enjoyable game. I mean, don't get me wrong, I'm sure it's very hard, but you know. I've played some hard games before. I played Battlefield 1 last night. Everyone was kicking my ass. I really fucking suck at Battlefield 1. Like, horrendously. What is this? Two moons colliding? No. They look more like planets. Why does this look so familiar? That is a picture of Gaia being assimilated by Terra. 5,000 years ago, Terra, already an old planet, sought to assimilate Gaia. Terra needed to merge with a younger planet to survive. However, there was already life on Gaia. And so the story began. Oh yeah, I saw this in Ulvert. Life on Terra was coming to an end. We had no choice but to proceed with the fusion, which tragically destroyed Terra's native civilizations. Terra was too old to be assimilated, or too old to assimilate everything. Thus, I created the Ifa Tree to regulate the flow of souls back to Terra. So, Garland is God. This is peculiar. We're also running upwards, which is really hard to control. You're stoked that Jason... oh, shocked that Jason doesn't have Final Fantasy Tactics. I don't think it's on PC. I've actually never played Tactics. I heard it's good, though. A lot of people have been saying that. This might be the final save point before Hades. In fact, I think it might be. Like, I think it really is. I think Hades might be in this room. We'll put it that way, from the description that I have here. They look like boobs. I did think one of them looked like it was a nipple, but, very weirdly colored for boobs. We'll put it that way. Kind of like gray with a big red thing for a nipple. There we go. This is how we get to Hades. I think he might be under the sea. Wow, we in ocean now. Fish everywhere. Yum yum. Get in my belly. What are you doing, you crazy goon? Swimming off to fish, Zidane. You help catch fish too. Eh. What this? Hard to breathe now. Eh, can't breathe. It's because you think we're inside an ocean. I can breathe fine. We not an ocean? Quinter is literally insane. Garland is actually not a god. Just a scientist. He is a messenger for them. He leads heroes to their destiny. Interesting. FF2 explains that really well. Okay, cool. Hello, Geo. How's it going? Hello, Magic. Fish all gone, I said. Me too. Right, so I believe... we should go safe so we don't have to watch that bloody cutscene again. Oh, of course, yeah. I do believe in that room, one with the fish. Just then, Garland is like behind, not Garland, fucking Hades is behind like the rock on the right or something like that. So here we go. Oh boy, this is gonna be a pain in the dick. My god, it takes forever to come out of the save point. Holy crap. All right, we got battles off. Good, good, good. Order potion is something we should equip though. Let's do that. Ability. We're gonna need some spare points on a couple of people. Yeah, like you. When you were... What can we get rid of? Good question. What is this? Nullifies magic element. I don't really know what that means. I don't really know what healer is. Restores the target's HP or life or energy or regen. I guess we don't really need MP plus 20%, and I should actually go save it. Oh, I should have saved it already. Yeah, we need to use a tank, so we're down a lot of MP. Let's go use our tent then, I guess. Let's speed it up. Ah! Tent! Why is the only thing that kills me in Dark Souls 3 when I replay it that freaking Katana dude? I hate that guy. Oh no, I've never had that much trouble with him. I beat him first time on my, I think it was on the Soul Level 1 run, and I think also... Actually, that might have been my first death. But I think I died to him once, and on the Magic Only run, I beat him first time as well. But then again, when you stay at a distance, he's really easy. So it's over here somewhere, I think. I'm gonna slow it down. Okay, so in memorial after a savior, we'll come across or come to a room where Quinta will swim after a fish. Once she is finished, search behind the ledge, and you will get a message asking you to leave at once. Okay. I mean, this is a ledge, is it not? Oh, there it is. Mysterious West, who dares disturb my sleep? Leave at once or you will die. No, suck my balls.
Prepare to die.
I might have to unequip the pumice on... God, shit. We don't have Quinna. That's a problem. We're not gonna have Angel Snack. Check out the music. But yeah, that's Hades, King of the Underworld and such.
Once you've defeated Ozma, I've come too far to retreat. Onward!
Isn't a throne and everything. What a badass. But yes, this is why we have a body temp on. He has curse. That's why he's a pain in the dick. Shadow damage, I'm pretty bloody sure, being the Lord of the Underworld and Hades and such, he's probably going to absorb shadow, so I'm not going to use Arc on him. Don't think that's going to be a great idea.
Flare!
Why is Hades underwater? Where's Poseidon? I have no idea what the logic is. I mean, we just fought a giant, you know, gobstopper bouncy ball marble thing. So, all logic went out the window a long time ago. Just, you know, strap yourself in and enjoy the ride. This game is batshit insane. Was that guy chilling behind the rock? I mean, I think so, yeah. Hades looks a lot different from the God of War series. Another series I have never played. Actually, no, I played a little tiny bit the first one, got really pissed off with the box pushing thing. But I watched some gameplay of like number 3 or something, and it looks awesome. So I do intend to get God of War eventually. I just wish it was on PC, but you know, say lobby. It's just easier for me to stream from PC. That's all there is to it. What you doing? Powering sword. Oh lord. Okay. I don't know how to stop that. Don't even know if there is a stop that. I say we just keep hitting him and hope for the best. I mean, if he's easier than Ozma, he shouldn't be too hard, to be honest. I mean, we don't have Angel Snack now, which is going to be a problem. Let's just hope he doesn't do curse. If he doesn't do curse, we're dandy. Yeah, get shocked, you bastard. Sweet. You want batshit insane? Play Metal Gear Rising Revengeance. I have. I completed it 2 or 3 times. I think I beat New Game Plus. Because you keep, like, Jetstream Sam's sword or something like that, and all the things that you've gathered. Pretty cool. Yeah, that's right, you get the sword in, like, the final boss fight, don't you? Let me try not to spoil too much, but yes, I think you get the sword in the final boss fight, and, yeah. Pretty sure you keep that in New Game Plus, and it's kind of awesome. But yeah, I beat it several times. Yeah. Take it. He's dead already. You were pathetic. Did he even hit me? You suck, Hades. God damn, that was a joke. So that's why he's like, oh, you beat Ozma, I'm fucked, basically, because, yeah, you ain't nothing on Ozma. That was pathetic. That really was pathetic. I commend you for overcoming me, I shall reward you for your impressive feat. Here's the cool thing. He ain't dead. You'll see. Bring two pumice pieces here and I will synthesize them for you. The end product is something only I can create. So this is the other way to get a pumice to get Ark. You can combine two pumice pieces. So, again, you don't need to be Ozma, but you need to be one of them. Hades, obviously, the easier of the two, as you saw. But yes, he's actually a synthesis dude now, I believe. Have you brought the items? Yeah, here you go. You can make a bunch of things that you can't make anywhere else, like this tin armor. And I think you can make a really good weapon. Here's the weird thing. You can make Save the Queen, which is Beatrix's sword. Only she can equip it. As you can see down the bottom, nobody can equip this sword. Beatrix is not a permanent party member. We had her very briefly. The only reason for this is that you can then throw it with Amaranth. So obviously it doesn't require expensive materials, but it's 50 grand a time. So this is a really powerful throwing weapon, basically. That's all it is. Oh, but yeah, you can see we can make pumice pieces as well. Oh, interesting. There's something else here. I think it's the tin armor, isn't it? Yeah, you need a hammer and an ore. The hammer you get from a side quest that we didn't do. I think not Quinna, what's his damn name? Cinna. I think Cinna gives it to you, because, you know, he's always walking around with a hammer. And, yeah, that's how you make the best armor for him in the game. Like I say, we didn't do that, and I don't really care to, because too much backtracking and what have you. So I need to clean my nerd glasses, one second. Beautiful, beautiful. All right, let's go! I should probably go back and save. Eh, alright, let's go back and save us as we beat him. The new DLC for Dark Souls 3 is out on Xbox, apparently. We don't know why it's out early, but it is. I guess if I have battles off, I can leave Auto Potion on. I suppose. Yeah, I do want to use a tent, though. But yeah, it ain't out on PC, and it ain't out on PS4 yet. It is supposed to be out, Tuesday? Yeah, Tuesday. In 4 days. Only 4 more days. And yes, I will be streaming that. It happens to fall, as I said, on a Tuesday, which is a solo stream day anyway. So, yeah. We will be streaming the DLC Tuesday unless something comes up like, I'm sick, basically. Or I'm literally dead. One of the two. Then I think we'll be... Oh, you know, my internet dies. Something, you know, completely unforeseen. Otherwise, yes, we'll be doing it Tuesday. Ta-da! So Gaia used to be just that one big ocean. Or just one big ocean. How do you know? I don't know. For some reason, it's in my memory. I wasn't even born at the time. It doesn't make any sense. I was born on Terra, not Gaia. So how can it be in my memory? It's in my memory too. Gaia used to be covered with water. I'm getting a similar feeling as well. Maybe that means all existence can be traced back to a single source. I don't understand. You and me both, buddy. You and me both. Oh yeah, we're gonna stream it. We are going to stream it. It's gonna be another bus! Man, did Hades... Did he actually hit us? I don't think he did. That was sad. Wow, that's... I think we found Cthulhu.
Your presence is forbidden.
I was too busy gawking at it to read what it said. It said something about Kraken. I guess he's the Kraken. Oh, he's got tentacles. That's adorable. Wait, can I cast Flare on multiple... I can't. Okay, it's just me to go then. Again, this is why we have body camp. Everything here tries to freeze you or burn you. Oh, really? You're returning it. We'll see how that goes. Fuck it, we'll use Ark. We can always speed it up. And you smack the Kraken, I guess. Does Clem Hazard work? Yes, Clem Hazard is on all three.
Beautiful! Beautiful.
That was quite pathetic damage to the Kraken there. The tentacles, fanfiction time indeed.
Water gear.
I like how he can get water gear, like a level 3 water spell. We can't even get a level 2 water spell, we just have water. It cures him? You bitch nugget! That sucks! Let's focus on one of the tentacles, I guess. Let's go for the left one. Maybe he's a lefty.
Eternal darkness! Super speed!
How long have we been going? Not too long, actually. We're pulling things off, man. Unlike the last stream, which was like 2 hours, and 2 hours and 20 minutes. Me dying to friggin' Ozma. What a difference 19 levels makes, right? Get out, teacher. You little slut bag. It's not done yet, is it? Oh god, it's so long. I forgot how long it was. There we go. Nope, nope, still going. Yay! 9999 everything. So how about those tentacles, eh? Yay! We did it. Wait, is the other one still alive? Oh, it is. Oh, no, never mind. It just took forever. Sure, it's just his bottom line. I doubt this thing's got much going for it now. He's like a sad little blue Cthulhu block man. Gonna go level up some more before I go back there. Went in like level 30 and found out it's recommended for 70 plus. Are we talking about the Dark Souls 3 DLC? Yeah, I did read that it's supposed to be tougher than anything in the main game, pretty much. I have a dude who's like 100 something, and it's got a bunch of cool gear. I think I have two dudes, actually. The one's like my strength character, one's my dex dude. Both of them should be good. I think it's just before the Deacons of the Deep, where you start it, something like that. So, yeah, I think I have a couple of characters prepared for it. I guess I'll probably use the Dex guy, because Dex is generally better for single player. But we'll see. Maybe I'll change my mind.
Mega Flare!
Can you just die now, Kraken buddy? Like, good lord. You're attacking it more than friggin' Hades did. Which just don't make no damn sense. Yeah, I love the style of this game, like how many secrets they have. Like, you see all those ghost dudes around here, this Hades hidden at the back of the room. Ozma's a thing. I mean, all the Chocograph hunting and all the things we did, there's still a bunch of side quests I haven't showed you. Like, there's a way to get Excalibur 2, which is the best sword for Steiner, but it's kind of long and complicated. There's the whole auction house thing. There's so many cool little things about this game. It's very grindy in places, as you've seen. I got an achievement called All Washed Up, because it's a Kraken. Genius. But, yeah, I love secrets in games like this. 7 had a shit ton of secrets as well, like some crazy ones. And a busted-ass clock. I had a feeling. Oh, it's invisible! I thought it was gonna be one of the ghosty dudes. It's an invisible save point. I'm glad I found that. Boop! It's a shitty place to put it. Deacons is pretty early, and apparently you can just stumble in. Interesting. See, I thought it was going to be like you click on a painting or something like that. What is this? Whoa, okay. Hang on a minute. I bet there's a car guy right up above. I knew it. A rare phantom. I'm the ghost of Card Master Empress. Are you challenging me to a game? Let's see what they have, I guess, since we did just save it. We probably won't win because I'm shit at this card game. We don't really have any good cards. Exactly. Hello? Okay. Now I remember how terrible our cards are. What do we have here? We have Alexander. That's cool. Okay, so there's a card called Airship, which is just like, I guess the airship from like Final Fantasy 1 or something? Weird. So it's got 6 power, or 6 physical, 6 defense, 6 magic defense. Pretty good card, actually. Hildegard 3 is not bad. Ooh, that one's good. Ooh. We have the Hildegard 1. The theater ship. That's a lot of bloody ships. Dark Matter card. Why the hell not? Odin, yeah. Oh, there's the Nova Dragon. So we already have the card of that thing. There's the Iron Man. And Ark. Ooh. Cool. Okay, we'll try this. Hello, Slykid, and hello, Jimbos. How you doing? Let's go here. We'll be all defensive. You fucking bitch. He's got the Hades card? Dude, that's sweet. Okay, interesting. We might win this fight. Yeah! Yeah! Combo breaker! You took it back. That's really annoying, because I want a Hades card. Okay, so, I remember what C means. I think the first number there of the last two is physical defense. So he has no magic defense, I think. So if we use a magic card on attack, like this one. Exactly.
Okay.
Six magic, five physical, three. Okay, he's got really high magic defense on this, but crap physical.
Yes! Ah, boss!
Oh, come on, we drew! Whatever. We'll just accept that. I don't really like the cards in this guy. I fucking love Triple Triad. I really don't like Tetramaster. But, you know, we at least, we held our own there. Jeez, that's one big fireball. Could it be a moon? This is the birth of Gaia. That's Gaia. Over 5,000 years ago, what's above that ladder? See for yourself. Not the way Garland's like trying to teach us history and Zidane's just interrupting the shit out of him. Tomb has a big flicker at the bottom. It does? Hang on, let me have a look. Alright, thank you for letting me know. Let me know if it pops up again. I'm trying to keep an eye on it. Terra reached the peak of its prosperity at this time. The people believed that their future was secure. Ultimately, their very hubris led to Terra's demise. Thus, I was created to deal with our plight. It stopped as you said that. Yeah, I actually have the very bottom of the preview window covered, so I wouldn't have seen it. I don't know what would be causing that, though, because there should be nothing doing that. But yeah, I'm trying to keep an eye on it. Like I say, let me know if it pops up again, and thank you. Is that another card guy? Yep.
I am the ghost of the card master who controls the dark. Are you trying to trick me?
No, fuck off. You've made a wise decision.
I don't want to, buddy. What's this? I got the Mace of Zeus. It's pretty sweet. What is that?
I have no idea.
Seems to be a legendary weapon, I think, for Eco, maybe? Yeah, I got an achievement called the Ultimate Mace.
Who else would use a mace? Is it yours?
Oh, it is yours. Oh, it teaches him Doomsday. Oh, my.
Don't mind if I do. That's pretty cool.
A little late, but you know, better than never.
Must have been the final boss is like immune to shadow or something.
I'm still seeing it. I'll say anything if I see it more though.
I'm like trying to see if it pops up.
I have no idea what would be causing it. I'm sure it's not just something in the game that's supposed to be flickering, because you know we're in a creepy weird place.
Yeah, I don't see it at the moment. But again, thank you for letting me know.
Hopefully it's not too distracting if it's just occasional, but yeah, I have no idea why that would be happening. What the hell?
I mean, I know you're one of the Mirror Guardians, but damn. I, the Earth Chaos Lich... I can't read that fast, man. But your life ends now.
Alright, sure, whatever.
Shocking.
Level 5 death. Unfortunate for you, 99 is not, you know... a multiple of 5, bitch. So you ain't gonna kill me with that. I think thievery does more damage depending on how much you've stolen. I don't know, let's just give it a try. Why not? Why not? I doubt it's gonna work, VV, but bless you for trying, my friend. Wait, if you're a lich, you're probably gonna be... life might just outright kill him. Let's just try. Because undead usually take damage from, you know, like life and curing spells and such.
Aha! He looks pretty undead. Let's give him a doomsday. It's gonna hit all of us, but I'm pretty sure we're all immune to it, so, you know. Why the balls nuts?
Yeah, thievery, bitch.
I'm waiting to see how much it does.
That was pathetic. Pathetic. For all of the stealing I've done?
Death cutter.
How dare you. You know what, just smack it. But if at any point you could cast this life... Oh god, the auto potions. Oh, she still has it, that's right. Oh, it misses.
Lame.
Yeah, I am gonna try it. I wanna see if Kyurigo will do damage to him. It was happening for you during the card game, but not during normal gameplay. Oh, interesting.
Okay.
Yeah! Then again, if you're a lich, you might be immune to shadow as well, because you know, like, shit, lich- Oh, God! That's my bad. I might have just wiped us out with Doomsday. I thought we were immune to that. Shit. This might kill us. Oh god, why? Okay, we're kind of alive. That was... Let's never do that again. Why did we not absorb it? It's supposed to do shadow damage, right? I still have all the stuff equipped that I had during the Ozma fight. I'm so confused. Whatever. I think we're gonna be fine because of all our life. Otherwise, that was a game over right there. Venom power. I don't care about that. I don't care. That's... Yeah, I... Whatever. I'm very confused why that killed us, but it did. It really did. But hey, we brought it back. Can you die now, sir? You're hanging in an awful long time. She's getting embarrassing now. Yeah. I think her transmode, by the way, where it changes summon to Eidolon, basically just makes the summon more powerful. Something like that. And you can't go over 9999, so, you know. It's a little redundant to use something like Ark, because he does 9999 anyway. Bahamut almost certainly will with the powered up version. So yeah, why sit through that long-ass animation? Can you not do that? Can you at least, like, miss, please? Miss. Ha-ha!
You sick. Prepare to die.
Get him, Bahamut. Yeah, you're a champ. Love it. That was actually pathetic. Never mind, I take it all back. How are you still alive? Thank you!
Good God.
It's the final boss, Jason. It's a post hanging there. That's not the final boss. That's the final of the four. The final boss, obviously, gonna be Kuja, in probably like 1,000 different forms. Hitting rock bottom is the achievement I got there. Hang on. Hitting rock bottom. It's called Lich. I'm trying to figure out, is that like a wrestling pun? I mean, I know it's a phrase, but like, normally the achievements, like, oh, hello. Normally the achievements make sense. Like, the names, they're puns and things. Hitting rock bottom? What's that got to do with a lich? I mean, the only thing I think of is, like, I beat him, and the rock bottom's a finisher, right, in wrestling? So, maybe that's where they're going with that? Because, like, I finished the last of the four Mirror Guardians? Whoa, why did it just tab out the game? That was weird. It could be Notepad messing this up, though. It's on the other screen. Let me close Notepad.
Get out of here. I don't need you anymore. You disgust me.
There we go. Actually, you know what I do need? I need this back up, then we bring the chat back up. Lovely. Alright.
He was snapping the dragon in High Wall of Lothric and nearly run out of arrows would have been so annoying.
Oh, yeah. What the... Whoa! There's nothing. Oh, that's right, he does represent Earth. I gotcha, rock bottom, because he even used Earthquake on me. Genius. I still think my wrestling theory was a genius one, but apparently I overthought that a little bit. Is this it? Is there nothing else?
Is there nothing else? This is space.
Whoa. Space.
Your journey is not over. Do not fear. Step forward and you will be closer to the truth. Go, Zidane. You stupid monkey boy.
It's easy for you to say.
This is a weird perspective.
Okay, I feel like I'm tripping balls right now. Am I controlling you? Oh, I am.
That was a random battle. I literally just switched off encounters because I was like, oh, we're not going to get any in here. Nope, totally fucking did. Oh, it's Behemoth, which I used to call Behemoth, which I think also sounds pretty cool, but no, it's Behemoth. Alright, I think we've already killed one of these. Let's just speed it the fuck up.
Let's use a cure guy, because it's probably going to beat my ass.
We'll give you a...
Oh, no. Don't accidentally use Doomsday. Good lord. Don't do that. Don't do that. Fuck it. Get out of here.
Yeah.
Let's turn battles right the hell back off, because that's just annoying. Whoa! Okay, that's trippy at super speed. I think I am moving him. How do I get to you? Whoa, what the hell?
You have entered a new realm. There are no more worlds. There is no more space. Follow your memory, your original memory, and march forth.
Garland, what exactly is our memory?
Why can I remember other people's experiences and events that happened before my time?
Garland, please tell me!
Do not limit memory to just one individual's experiences from birth. That is only the surface. Every life born into this world, whether natural or artificial, requires a parent. And that parent also requires a parent. And the parent's parent requires a parent. Life is connected one to another. If you trace the root of all life, there exists one source. The same can be said for memory. All life constitutes an intelligence that holds memory beyond experience. Memory is not isolated within individuals. It is an accumulation of generations of memories that continues to evolve. You can say that memory and evolution go hand in hand. But most life forms do not understand the true nature of memories. Which explains why most memories never cross paths. So what am I going to find by tracing back our roots? A presence that presides over all life and memories, the crystal. Crystal? You are on your own now. Zidane, take care of Kuja. And protect the crystal. Farewell. You'll find in almost every Final Fantasy game, crystals are just the most important bloody thing. In fact, if you look at the logo for Final Fantasy IX, it's the words Final Fantasy IX with a bloody giant crystal in the background. This is the first time we've heard of this fucking crystal. The whole game, I'd like to point out.
Garland, wait! I don't remember if I already read that. Garland! You prick!
Even if I were created to serve one purpose alone, I do not regret being born to this world. That's very blinding, holy shit. He's the memory of all people on Gaia, calling it, maybe. Is this the crystal that Garland was talking about? It's time for us to find out the truth. Check out the music, it's all crystally and shit. Is there another save point here? I'd really appreciate one. Probably just the final boss now, they're like, yeah, fuck it, do it. Whoa. You think they would give me a non-invisible save point now, right? Like, before the boss? Or are they not going to be that generous? Probably not going to be that generous. I'm, like, clicking all around, trying to find it. Oh, good. Okay, well, this will be the last bastion before the boss. Yep, you can even teleport out now. Because they're like, look, you don't want to run all the way back, let's be honest here. You're right, I don't. But we ain't leaving. We're in this to finish it. I did not think we'd actually have time to finish it this stream. It looks like we're going to do it within time quite handily. This excites me. I mean, it depends how much we die to the final boss. We might die to the final boss. We might not. Again, it depends if he's tougher than Ozma. I don't think he is. But it could be wrong. We'll see. Again, it's been a long time. I barely remember what the final boss is. Other than, you know, Kuja.
Kuja!
He's still all trancy and feathery and shit. Nice of you to come. I'm surprised you beat the four chaoses that I created from the crystal's memory. But you're too late. Take a good look, isn't it beautiful? It's the original crystal. This is where it all began. The birthplace of all things. Once I destroy it, everything will be gone. Gaia, Terra, the universe, everything. Your lives and memories too, of course.
Shut up! You bastard. The only thing that's gonna be gone is you. I'll take you out right now.
You honestly think you can beat me? Even if you do, Gaia's already doomed. Its assimilation by Terra has begun, and the Ivy Tree will incite a cataclysmic destruction of Gaia. It's all over for you and your friends. See, I win, either way. It doesn't matter. Even if Gaia is assimilated, the planet will remain. We'll start over to make a new home.
Kuja, you're nothing but a coward. If you're gonna die, leave us out of it.
Why should the world exist without me? That wouldn't be fair.
If I die, we all die. Zidane, you'll be my first sacrifice.
Let's get on!
It's time to spank the final boss, everyone.
Time to fucking do it.
I'm very excited.
Whoa.
You are not the final boss. You're that thing that was guarding the mirror. Or the mirror... all of the mirrors. You're that thing. You know, the thing. Death guys. Yeah, that thing.
Alright. Don't use Doomsday. Just don't ever do it. I'm bloody terrified I'm gonna accidentally click it now.
What are we summoning? Sure. Let's go for Bahamut.
I don't want to sit through Ark again.
Otherwise, he's like, you'll be my first sacrifice, and Death Guys just pops up like, what up? Oh, you were expecting someone else?
Well, actually, yes. This will be the point where we'll spend, like, literally an hour, even if we don't die, just fighting, like, different versions of Kuja and things that he summons. Because they always do this in Final Fantasies. It's more of just a JRPG thing in general. They motherfucking love having multiple phase final bosses. To just a ridiculous degree. I mean, if you saw the end of Final Fantasy VIII, it was very much like that.
Yeah!
I mean, I doubt Death Guys is gonna have that much HP. This boss has many phases. I expect he does. The boss music for Kuja is really awesome. Yeah, I hope it's different when he pops up. This is just the regular boss music right now. Hey, how's it going, Kirsty? You're just in time for the final boss. How are you? Yeah, we've seen it, Bahamut. We've seen it. It's cool and everything, but we've seen it.
Aha!
Okay, not terrible. Death Guy is kind of tanky. Gonna say kind of tanky. How are you alive? Like, how are you alive? I doubt he'll survive another barrage. He's probably about to kick bucket. Just woke up, you're gonna straighten your hair and watch on the TV. Okie dokie. Hey, there we go. I had a feeling. Alright, bring it on, Kuja. How did they beat Death Guys? Well, I mean, you know, he was a bit shit. Do you really think you can beat me? I mean, if I don't, we ain't gonna finish the game, so it's gotta happen, my friend. Aww, I was hoping he was just gonna descend from the sky. That'd have been cool.
Like, what up? I'm Kuja, bitch.
Can I go back and save it now? I think I can. Totally can, can't I? Yeah, let's do that. So if we die, we don't have to do Death Guys again.
Haha! Just give me a second, Kuja. Just need a little pit stop.
You killed Bahamut in Final Fantasy XIV. I can also use Mega Flare. Suck it, Jason. I can use Doomsday and kill my entire team. Suck it, Kirsty. Yeah, you missed me killing the Gobstopper from... I almost said George of the Jungle, and I have no idea why. My brain went, Harry Potter, George of the Jungle. From Charlie and the Chocolate Factory.
I killed it. First time, in fact. If we don't count, you know, all the times I died.
First time at level 99.
Can't believe you beat Death Guys. Well, my time is almost up. Time to die, everyone.
Did he just hip thrust at me?
Okay.
Why would I want to kill my own team? Well, I mean, I didn't. I didn't realize it was gonna happen. Check out the music. I'm rocking out right now. He's even called Trance Kuja, because see, that's not used Doomsday. It's not due there. Oh, you have Flare too. That's adorable. We might actually want Quinna for this, just so we can use Mighty God. We'll see how it goes without him. I mean, he, at least at this stage, because he's going to have multiple phases, he ain't going to be tougher than friggin' Ozma. Trance Kuja shouldn't be a problem, but he's probably going to, you know, morph like 1,000 times, like a freaking nemesis from Resident Evil or something. They're opening a hog... Hang on. Awesome music. Bahamut's kind of making a lot of noise. I'm trying to listen to the music. Get him, Bahamut! That's pretty badass. Right, anyway. Apparently they are opening a Hogwarts school somewhere in France. People are crazy. They are indeed. They are indeed. This, you aren't kidding, this music's badass, dude. Oh, I remember Flarestar. Hopefully we'll be good. I'll get ready to use like an Elixir or something if we need to. Wish we could learn Flarestar. I'm pretty sure Doomsday is the best spell for Vivi. That kind of hurt. I'm gonna do it. We have so many Elixirs, we may as well. I don't think we'll need it, but just in case. Vivi always seems to take the most damage. Maybe it's just because he has low HP in general, but Dagger seems to generally be fine compared to him. Kyurega? You little bitch. Get shot. FF9, we're finding a giant magical floating chicken man is how you save the world, indeed. After, you know, a bouncy ball in Hades who literally didn't attack us. He tried, bless him. He raised his sword, and by that point he was dead.
Grand Lethal!
I like the way his head's all shiny, because you can see he's got like Reflect or something on him. They only have 100 spots in 4 days or something. There is a Quidditch class. Will they teach them to fly on brooms, I wonder?
I mean, you never know.
You never know. I wouldn't put it past them. Yeah, everyone's getting trounced the fuck up. How do you like it? We can trust too, man. Should I get the short summon animation now? Not really, no. Don't know why suddenly we're getting all the long ones. Weird. Hey, there goes Trance Kuja. Totally that was the final boss, though, I swear.
Ugh.
I'm gonna die anyway. I won't have to be afraid anymore. But I'm not gonna die alone.
You're all coming with me.
Oh, this is his final blow in this face, Ultima. That's adorable. Can we learn Ultima? I don't think we can we? Because... Wait, did I learn it already on Vivi and I've forgotten? I don't think you can. I'm sure before Doomsday, Flare is the best spell. Maybe Ultima is just something only the enemies can have.
Eh.
What happened to the crystal? Where is this? You stand before the final dimension, and I am the darkness of eternity. Who are you? All life bears death from birth. Life fears death, but lives only to... What? Oh, but lives only to die. It starts with anxiety. Anxiety becomes fear. Fear leads to anger. Anger leads to hate. Hate leads to suffering. Suffering leads to the dark side. The only cure for this fear is total destruction. Kuja was a victim of his own fear. He concluded he could only save himself by destroying the origin of all things, the crystal. What the heck are you talking about? Why are you telling me all this? Now the theory is undeniable. Kuja's action proves it. All things live to perish. At last, life has uncovered this truth. Now it is time to end this world. Holy shit, it's Yoda. Exactly. What do you mean by that? I exist for one purpose. To return everything back to the zero world where there is no life and no crystal to give life. In a world of nothing, fear does not exist. This is the world that all life desires. Who the hell do you think you are? You're not ending anything. Never. Not as long as we have the will to live.
Foolish creature. Your fears have already deluded you.
One day you will choose destruction over existence as Kuja did. When he sought to destroy the crystal, the purpose of life ended. Now, come. Enter the zero world that you desire. No! We will destroy you and prove you wrong. And through our memories, future generations will see that we can overcome any fear. How brave of you, Zidane.
We can't give up now. We have to fight together.
Even if we lose, it doesn't matter. Our memories will live on inside others. So even if we are born to die, I'm not afraid.
I'm gonna live.
So we get to select our party members. Apparently we begin this fight all at 1 HP. That's a bit shitty. Okay, so... Let me put it this way. I know who the final boss is, kind of. Kuja is gone, I'm pretty sure. That was Kuja. I thought he had more phases than that. No, that was him. He's done. This is someone else, in case you couldn't tell. It may or may not be Yoda. We'll see. Come back after you kill bad guy. I prepare a big meal for everyone. Guess everyone else that we didn't pick is gonna teleport away or something? Oh, we like absorbing their HP or some weird shit? We are, aren't we? That's weird. Don't screw up. Why do those heroes always have speeches? Take a page from Doctor's book. He kills shit and doesn't talk at all. Yeah. I don't know. I mean, in a way, I kind of like it. Yeah, remember, this is a very old game. It was less of a trope back when they made it. It's very tropey now. I leave everything in your hands. Oh, Freya, we barely used you. We really barely used you. Nobody likes the Rat Lady. I do think the Dragoon's one of the coolest classes, though. But I'm just saying, Kane in Final Fantasy IV, clearly the coolest Dragoon in the entire series. Promise me you'll win. I'm promising shit. Wait, so Yoda is a Sith here and Zidane is a Jedi. Pretty much, oh, we did absorb their HP. That's funky. That's funky fresh. Does everybody have auto potion? I believe so. I don't know what the boss uses. Let's just assume that maybe it can stop us. I don't know. So we'll get rid of ability up, because goddamn do we not need that. And we'll put on locomotion if we can. You are kind of... I guess if I'm not going to steal, I can get rid of bandits. And master thief, wherever that is. And then we can equip locomotion. And I mean, like, sure? Insomniac, I suppose? Yeah, why not? Why not? And we'll even put, I don't know. Fucking... mug on? Whatever. How we doing here? You don't have locomotion either. Let's get rid of level up, because you don't need level up. I don't know why I have these equipped. Sure, you can float. Why not? Why the hell not? Alright, looks good to me, man. Let's do this!
Don't stop me now. I'm having such a good time.
We've come too far to lose now. Let's just wrap this up and go home, all of us. The music hasn't changed. So this is the creepy-ass final boss music. Are you ready? This is the final boss of the game. No, it is not Kuja. What is it? Bloody good question. Looks weird though, right? Yeah. Yeah, it does. So its name is Necron. So I looked up some lore on this. Nobody knows what it is, really. Essentially, it seems that, how do I describe this? Basically, people seem to think it is death itself. Like, it is death. Nothing more than that. Like, it desires every, like, life to end. It's the incarnation of death, so go with that. If you overthink it, you're going to get confused because, I mean, damn, I don't even know if the developers knew. But yeah, this is it. That was the only phase of Kuja, which really surprised me. I thought I remembered him having like 3 or 4 phases, but I guess I'm wrong. Oh, the music changed. He is protected. Can I dispel that? Do I have to dispel? Is dispel even a thing in this game? Can I stop his protect? Because that's really annoying. I don't think I can I? Son of a bitch. Son of a bitch. Alright. Blue shockwave? That's adorable. It missed? You suck! Alright, summon again. That is a disappointing final boss then. I mean, I guess. It's one of those things. I enjoyed the game so much. I don't think it's really that big of a deal. You know, you gotta remember, we fought a giant bouncy ball, and... like, a lot of the bosses in this game just come from the deep recesses of some, like, insane dude's mind. Like, none of this really makes that much sense. you got the storyline about, you know, worlds being eaten by other worlds, and this thing wants no life to exist, and, you know, you've got Garland, which is essentially kind of supposed to be like a messenger of the gods, kind of like Muhammad, I guess, if you want to look at him that way from what people were saying. It's a cool boss. Like, I like the design, I like the way he looks. He's not easy. It would have probably been more fitting if it was Kuja, but we thrashed Kuja. He was easy. Probably wouldn't have been so easy had we not grinded. That's the thing. That's a problem with a lot of Final Fantasy games, or a lot of RPGs in general, is you grind so hard to make your characters really strong to take on the optional stuff. The optional stuff is almost always harder than the final boss. Like, one game I really want to play on camera, and I will be doing at some point, but I'll be recording it, because damn, why not streaming that, because it's very grindy, is a game called Ligeia 2. Ligeia 2 is fucking amazing, but the final boss of that game is way fucking easier than most of the optional stuff. There are some insanely tough challenges in that game. There is a thing called the Centurion Challenge, which literally takes about 2 hours to do. You have to do 100 battles in a row. There is 100 walls. You walk into a wall, you battle something. You walk into the next wall, you battle something. Just like down a long-ass corridor. 100 battles. The last like 5 or 10 are harder than the final boss. You can go from like level 70 to 99 taking on those 100 battles. The Centurion Challenge is way harder than the final boss of that game. It's just one of those things that happens a lot. I mean, I guess, yeah, it's maybe disappointing that the final boss is so mysterious and things like that, but I kind of like that. That's almost like the Dark Souls route. Like, you don't really know exactly what this thing's purpose is or what it really is. Again, it's speculation that this thing is death itself. People don't really know. Like, it's an incarnation of death. Grand Cross. I think that move might hurt like hell, so let's get ready to use an Elixir or something. You think he's an aspect of the Void from Final Fantasy... Is that 4? Yeah, 4. One that can only manifest in the crossroads between life and death, the Void has been theorized to connect all of the different Final Fantasy universes. It could be that thing. The Void. He seems very, very sci-fi. We seem to be fine, even though he just grand-crossed us. Don't know exactly what that move was, but that looked terrifying. If I had that body, I'd pull all the birds. Yeah, he is quite chiseled. I say he. Who knows? I mean, it does appear to have boobs. Am I wrong about that? Like, it's even got its arms crossed as if it's covering the nipples, because, you know, you're not allowed to see lady nipples, you can only see man nipples. Oh, you are nearly dead, Steiner. Holy shit. Let's use an Elixir on Steiner. Actually, suddenly he has a ton more HP. I don't know what happened there. Whatever. Probably going to be a long boss. Probably very tanky on the HP front. Sorry to disappoint that it's mysterious, just that it appears out of nowhere without any context unless I'm missing something. I mean, yeah, but... I get what you're saying. I don't necessarily disagree with that. They could have set it up better, like maybe had some hints about it and things like that. It would have been maybe cool if Garland showed up again, because clearly he ain't really dead. Stop protecting yourself, you dick. But yeah, it almost seems like it has boobsicles. Because, I mean, they could just be really bulgy pecs. But those look like boobs to me, and again, the fact that it's got its arms crossed, because, you know, not allowed to see lady nipples. Could be a lady. Or it could be, like, some genderless thing, I don't know. But either way, it's ripped as fuck. I mean, that's a great APAC. I think X-Death uses the Grand Cross in FFBE. What is BE? Oh, hey, we made it! Second! But yeah, I didn't think that was going to be tough after Ozma. I mean, I did point it out. Why defer your fate? So maybe I ain't dead yet. You dead yet? I'm confused why the music would still be going. Is the will to live that powerful? Oh no, I think it's dead. It seems to be exploding. Look away for 2 minutes, and y'all get weird. Yes, we do tend to do that. I can't even... I was gonna say they tend to do that. I mean, I'm as much to blame as anyone. That death animation, though. This is not the end. Yeah, it does seem to be... I am eternal.
As long as there is life and death... Okie dokie. I thought it had something else to say then. It's just, it's eternal as long as there is life and death. Interesting. See, I kind of like how ambiguous it is.
What up with the tentacle pole, man?
That's kind of terrifying. Are you alright? Yeah. Look at what's happening. So what Ku just said was true. The Ifa tree is beginning its violent reaction. What's gonna happen? I don't know, but it doesn't look good. We're all gonna die! Hooray! I doubt anyone could have survived that explosion.
No!
Captain? They are still alive. What's... Where are they? Over there. The Horde Guard is probably closer. You, the tall one. Sir. Hagen Pluto Knight the Eighth, ma'am. I didn't ask for your name. Contact the Helder Guard right away. Yes, sir. Ma'am, sir. Suave. Please be alive. Y'all just beat the shit out of it again if it comes back. Yeah, we did kind of whoop its ass. Sire, we're receiving a transmission from the Red Rose. Punch it up on the mainland. Not the mainland. That's a different thing entirely. You can call that later tonight. This is the Red Rose. You're not General Beatrix? Who are you? My name is Makoto. Everyone is alive. You are very close to them. What? How do you know? I can hear him. Who? I believe Makoto was the female monkey... Almost said monkey boy. The female monkey chick that the name picked up. Prepare to land immediately. I'm sensing a love triangle between him, her, and Garnet. Just saying. That's the Helder God 3. Looks like Sid came to rescue us. Sid! Thank heavens you're all safe. Come quickly, we don't have much time. Female monkey chick, hot, indeed. If you're into that sort of thing. Which I ain't. Farewell, Zidane. Ah, damn it. What's wrong? Why don't you go on ahead? I'll catch up with you all later. I have to take care of something. What? He's still alive. He can't be. Zidane, what are you doing? Steiner, take care of Dagger. What? What do you mean by that? Kuja's still alive. I can't just leave him. Oh, okay. Fair enough. This is ludicrous. Just because you two are from the same planet doesn't mean... No, that's not the reason. Come on, Zidane. Why are you doing this? Because I might have done the same thing if I were in his shoes. I probably would have fought against you guys and wreaked havoc in Gaia like he did. I know it sounds crazy. But I know, deep down inside, I have to do this. You're not crazy, Zidane. But you go help Kuja, not good idea. It is too dangerous. What do you mean, help Kuja? I'm confused. I can't just leave him. There's no way I could live with myself. I'm going. You're making a big mistake. Maybe, but we all have to make big decisions in life sometimes. For me, now that's time. I have to face up to it, just like Vivi did when he confronted his fears to find out about himself. That was a big decision for Vivi. I don't know about that. I don't think it was really a big deal. That's what you think, but I might not be doing this if it weren't for you. You've definitely taught me to take life more seriously. Well, you're obviously not going to change your mind, so I'm coming with you. No, you're not. I never use you. The principle of knighthood requires that one assist his comrade in times of need. I shall accompany you as well. Well, wait a minute. Like I said, it's my moment, so don't butt in. You guys will have your own someday. Besides, you guys have more important things to worry about, like Bemisia and Alexandria. For once in your life, why can't you be honest? Sorry, but I can't. I can't just walk away. It goes against my nature. You're a real simpleton. Forget it, guys. There's no stopping this fool. What are you still doing out here? Get on board right now. Come on, let's just leave him and get out of here. That guy will never change.
All right, you heard the man. Get out of here before it's too late. Do we get a one-on-one Kuji now? Or is this just going to be a cutscene or something? I don't know. I don't remember. Zidane, I love you. You'd better come back. That's creepy. You're like 6 years old. Zidane, I need to eat more different food. I'm still hungry. You need to come back. Take me more places. Show me more food. That's less creepy. Thank you. I love Vivi too. I still can't believe you're doing this. You've changed, Zidane. You've changed. Till we meet again. Fare thee well, monkey man. Zidane, you've taught me another big lesson in life. Thanks.
Zidane!
Princess, we must go. Dot 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 dot. Dagger, I mean, your highness. The abduction is over. I can't take you any further. I'm sorry for being so selfish. No, you're not being selfish. You've done so much for us. If it weren't for you, I probably would have led a meaningless life. A rich, rich princess with nothing to do but laze around and eat food. With you, I was able to see so much of the world and meet so many people. We faced many hardships too, but I think I finally know what's important. Booty. Booty is important. I'm so fortunate to have met you. I'll never forget our trip together. Thank you, Zidane. You're welcome. Now piss off so I can kill Kuja. No, it's sappy. Just go now. Promise me one thing. Please come back.
I can't promise you a damn thing, bitch. I'm going in. And I'm probably not coming back.
Quina does have her priority straight. You're not wrong. See, I don't remember if we actually do face Kuja in like a one-on-one, or if it's just a cutscene. I don't remember. Or maybe this is just the end of the game. Maybe we never get to see that part. I'm ruining the moment. It's what I do. Exactly. It's going out in a blaze of glory, maybe. Kuja, can you hear me?
I'm coming to get you.
I'm gonna play hide and seek. It's gonna be delightful. You still have time? Forget about me and Gil. Just shut up and stay where you are. I don't understand you. Okay. There goes nothing.
Oh my.
Here I am to save the day! This is trippy as balls. You're watching this, it reminds me that there's so many Final Fantasy games where they do this, where they're like running along a route or a, you know, a long pole or something as things are exploding around them. Definitely happens in 8, and it definitely happens in 10. Does it happen in 7? Yeah, it happens in 7 as well. So 7, 8, 9, 10 at least.
What up? I'm fucking Trinity from the Matrix. Pleased to meet you.
And then I fell. Whew. Still alive. It's FF version of rooftops, indeed. I guess that was pretty crazy.
Pretty goddamn crazy.
This is the pitter-patter of his feet. Hey, are you alright?
Zidane, why do you give a shit?
Great question. Can we have a one-on-one now? What are you doing here? I thought I told you to go. Wouldn't you do the same for me if you knew I was dying?
Never mind.
Your comrades were able to escape. Yeah, I knew you had something to do with it. I'm glad they made it. Why is Kuja a good guy now? I don't really understand. Yeah, well, it's our turn to get moving.
I don't deserve to live after all that I've done. I agree. Can I kill you now? I'm useless to this world. No one's useless. You helped us escape, remember? After you guys beat me, I had nothing left, nothing more to lose. Then I finally realized what it means to live. I guess I was too late. Hey! Don't you go dying on me, alright? Look, I'm just saying, I'd rather just fight the man. He was a dick the entire game. I'm not so forgiving, quite clearly. Kuja, what you did was wrong. But you gave us all one thing, hope. We were all created for the wrong reason, but you alone defined our fate. We do not want to forget this, we want your memory to live on forever. To remind us that we were not created for the wrong reason, that our life has meaning. Sometime later. So yes, I like the canon that you came up with in the chat. 10 out of 10. Kuja would later turn into a giant lizard that attacked Japan. So this is Alexandria. Pick up the pace, will ya? I don't believe it! Vivi! Vivi? How do you know that name? What are you talking about? It's me, Puck. How can you forget me? Puck? You know, Puck. The Prince of Amicia? Oh, come on. What's wrong with you? If you're not Vivi, then who are you? I am... Vivi's son. Vivi's son? Yeah. Look at all the Vivis! It's both glorious and terrifying! I always talked about you, Zidane, how you were a very special person to us because you taught us all how important life is. Freya, you're leaving soon, are you not? Yes, I can hardly wait to see everyone. See, I'm wondering who Vivi was born in. Alexandria, I went there many years ago. Also, how does a puppet have babies? I have so many questions. How long will it take to rebuild Bemisia? I don't care, as long as I'm with you, baby. And then they put their hands down each other's pants. I love you, Freya. Yet he still doesn't remember our past. I just want to cherish our time right now. You told me that life doesn't last forever, that's why we have to help each other and live life to the fullest. It's time to say goodbye to this room. That's some rat and rat action. Save the queen, you have served me well. Call a sword in the game that you can never use, my duty is finished here. Farewell, Alexandria. Even if you say goodbye, you'll always be in our hearts, so I know we're not alone anymore. And then Amara just fell down that hole in the bridge, and that was how he ended. Hey! Why are you going to Alexandria? I remember her, she was one of those bounty hunters. I forget her name. You're not going? She was with Amara at the time. I never said that. Well, I guess they weren't really together. They kind of didn't like each other. Hey, wait! Why was I born? How I wanted to live? Thanks for giving me time to think. Good food, not only delicious. Good food made with hearts. This is very important when cooking for friends. I mean, unless you want to fuck with them, then you put a bunch of spice in. To keep doing what you set your heart on, it's a very hard thing to do. We were also courageous. Lonnie, that's right, yeah. Hurry, hurry! We gotta get there before the play begins. Haha. There's no need to hurry. I talk very slow. The theater ship is no match for my new ship. My new Hildegard is the fastest ship ever. Do I have to remind you? You said the same thing about the theater ship, and that thing sucked. Ahem. That's what you said, father. Ikko, what did you just call me? Darling, she called you father. Has she been adopted or something? Father, mother, hurry. So say it again, Ikko.
Call me daddy.
What to do when felt lonely? When I felt lonely. That was the only thing you couldn't teach me, but we need to figure it out. The answer to balls. Need to read quicker, apparently. Beatrix! Where are you going? I don't look creepy over here at all. Please don't ask. My mind is already set. Wait, listen to me. Is he on the bush? Thump, 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 thump. What the hell? I never wish to lose you again. Steiner, you're awful at this. Let us protect the queen together. I wonder what Steiner looks like without, you know, his helmet on. What if he has hair? I'm so happy I met everyone. I wish we could have gone on more adventures, but I guess we will have to say goodbye someday. Beatrix is hot. You're not the only one that thinks that. There is a lot of fan art of Beatrix. Like, more than any other character, I'm pretty sure. Alright, you scumbags. We're almost here. Been a long time since we saw Alexandria. Let's give them a show they won't forget.
Yeehaw!
Break a leg, people. Everyone, thank you.
Farewell.
My memories will be part of the sky. Yeah, there's a lot of non-pornographic fan art of Beatrix. There's also a lot of pornographic fan art of her. The theater ship will be arriving soon. It's been so long. I can't wait to see everyone. Is it just, she has a giant head, does she not? Like, it doesn't seem to be proportionate to her body. But it'll never be the same. I have to let go of the past. Your dagger gets no booty. I have to move on, just like he taught me. Even Rusty gets some booty, but not Dagger. I like to think her and Beatrix have a thing going on, just because it's hot. Ladies and gentlemen, tonight's performance is a story that takes place long, long ago. Our heroine, Princess Cornelia, is torn from her lover, Marcus. She attempted to flee the castle only to be captured by her father, King Leo. Tonight's story begins when Marcus and Cornelia decide to run away together. And now, Your Royal Majesty, Queen Garnet, Lord Steiner, and Lady Beatrix. Noble ladies and lords, and our rooftop viewers, Tantalus proudly presents, I want to be your goddamn canary. Is he wearing a British flag for a shirt? It kind of looks like one. Take these notes, sheet. Have a good night, man. Marcus? Sweet Marcus, I fear I love thee more than I should. Princess, wilt thou be happy married to a lowly peasant such as I? Prithee, call me princess no more. Marcus, wilt thou truly cherish me, the king's only daughter? Or is such a desire too dear to wish for? After our nuptials, Shall I become no more than a puppet? A mindless puppet, never to laugh, never to cry. I wish to live my life under the sky. At times I shall laugh, at other times cry. For no life is more insincere than that lived as a masquerade. So much consideration thou hast given it, but worry not. Cast away the trappings of royalty, and I shall swaddle thee in a gown of pure love. Pray, my love, make me thy canary to keep forever in the cage of thy bosom. Let us embark on the first ships tomorrow, before dawn could tell of our something. All our fortunes are thy foot I lay, and I shall follow the... No cloud, no squall shall hinder us. Ha! Get it? Cloud and squall. That's beautiful. Oh, love is the sweetest joy and the wildest woe. All I wish is to be by my sweet Marcus's side. Yeah, I'm not skipping this text. It's going at its own pace, so I have to be really quick. Fee! It shall be a war. Bloody hell. Ne'er will I let their plan come to... Bloody hell, man! Good day to ye, Highness.
Good day?
Wist thee of Marcus? Marcus, what news dost thou bring? This.
Damn!
He fucking gut punched her! Did they get the lines from the Bible? Jeez, I don't know. The time for our departure is long past.
What is it called, like, a sugar daddy?
It is indeed. Where is Cornelia? Thank you for the tip, Stingray. You are very kind, sir. Marcus, the ship soon embarks. I'll read it in a moment. Board ye this boat alone, and peace could come to both kingdoms as blanks of false. Speak, Marcus! She told me that she could not live without me. I need to read really fast, apparently. So the sun is our enemy too, the eastern sky grows bright. Will you not spread our wings as yonder birds enjoy us flight? Hark, Marcus, they cannot wait any longer. The ship departs. Could she have betrayed me? Nay, ne'er would my love speak false. I must have faith. She shall appear if I only believe. All you have to do is believe. As the sun lends me no ear, I pray instead to the twin moons. I beseech thee, wondrous moonlights, grant me my only wish. Bring my beloved dagger to me.
See what we did there.
Bloody hell, that was hard to keep up with our reading. Again, thank you, Stingray. You're incredibly generous. Do not bankrupt yourself on my behalf. But I really do appreciate it, man. I'll read your message in a minute. And then everyone explodes. The end. Is it just me or does her head look more proportionate now? No, it's still kind of huge. But then again... No, it does look more proportionate than it does in the game. Like, outside of the cutscenes. Bitch got a massive head in the game. Get away, you weird rat thing. The hell is that? Is that the thing that Eco gave her? It looks like a weird shell. Maybe a Sedain's gonna pick it up and give it to her. It's like the glass slipper from Cinderella. Well, she gives no fucks. Alright, I don't think beating the shit out of him is going to be, you know, all that productive. That was awesome. How did you survive? I didn't have a choice. I had to live. I wanted to come home to you. So, I sang your song. Our song. Am I ready for Tuesday, the Dark Souls DLC? Absolutely, yes. Alrighty, so that was Final Fantasy IX. Let me check this message really quick. Wait, what the hell? Wait, what? Oh, it's over. Why do I have two instances of Google? What the hell am I doing? Alright, one second. I gotta reconnect. Oh my god, Twitch alerts, you suck. There you go. As Scorpion once said, get over here. Again, thank you, Stingray, for the $75 donation, sir. You're extremely kind. You really are. Can I skip the ending? I don't think I can. I don't know if there's any off-the-credits scene or anything like that. Yeah. That's gonna do for today's stream. I know it's gonna be a little bit shorter than usual, but yes. This Tuesday, we will be doing the Dark Souls 3 DLC for as long as it takes on the solo stream. Solo streams are gonna be Tuesday and Friday, unless something comes up. When we finish that, I'm gonna make a poll. Probably will post it as a YouTube video, and I'll put like 10, 15-ish games on there or something like that. Things I've bought that I think people might be somewhat interested in seeing me play. Not going to include RPGs because they're too bloody long to stream for the most part. And yes, whichever one wins the poll will be the first one we play. Again, it's going to be stuff like Shovel Knight, Aragami, blah blah blah. What's the other one? There's tons of them. You get the point. So yes, like I say, that's going to do it for today's stream. Thank you all for joining me. That was Final Fantasy IX. Fucking awesome game. Super grindy at parts. Like super duper 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 grindy. Like really, really grindy at parts. Let me turn down the music a little bit. We'll put it down. That's good. Yeah, I really like this game. Having replayed it, bearing in mind that I always considered it 8 my favorite one, this is definitely up there. Like this 7, 8. Are fucking amazing. I really love number 4 as well. I haven't finished 4 yet. I'll probably do that in my own time. I'm trying to think. There are definitely aspects of this that I prefer to 8, but there are definitely aspects of 8 that I prefer. I think the combat system in this is, like, vastly fucking superior. The only problem is, because it's, all... In 8, for example, 8 works like Oblivion in the sense that if you're level 99, all the enemies are level 99. If you're level 10, all the enemies are level 10, even like the final boss and shit. In fact, I think the only one that was the exception to that was like Omega Weapon, who I think is always level 100 in 8 for some reason. So in 8, you never had to grind. Except that you had to grind in a way to absorb the magic, so it still had its own grindy system there, but it wasn't half as bad. Whereas in 9, I had to do a shitload of grinding at points. Particularly to be Ozma, as you saw. Going from 80 to 99, that took quite a while. But yeah, other than the grindy parts, I think this game is fucking awesome. Yeah, the that whole Necron dude being super obscure was super obscure, but I liked it, you know? I liked it. I thought the ending was very cool. Yeah, very sappy, but it is what it is. Anyway, thank you for watching. I will see you Tuesday for the Dark Souls 3 DLC Ashes of Ariandel. Good night, everybody, and goodbye. And once again, thank you for the donation, Stingray. You're awesome.